Hi, I'm Brinda Miller. I'm a fine artist and I work from home these days because I have some very small paperworks to work on. My studio is a little far away from here, so I cannot go there at all. But once all this is over, I do hope that I can go back there and start working on something very new. And of course, I'll be working on very large works only because I haven't been able to and I feel the need to. I've always liked to change my work, so I'm hoping, of course, that there will be a huge kind of alteration in whatever I do in terms of thoughts. Luckily, I've had a lot of time to gather my thoughts together. A lot of time for introspection, a lot of time for retrospection, and a lot of time to think about our altered circumstances, as I do hope that all the artists are doing the same. They should be thinking about the working environment. They should be thinking about, you know, how things can be better, not just climate-wise, but also how we can optimize our time work-wise. In my younger days, I used to be very inspired by a lot of abstract artists, mostly abstract because my style is also abstract, and Barve maybe was one of my I used to really look up to his work, and the same with Nelly Gobai, and later on even Zarina Hashmi, and I admire their work a lot. And over the years, I've been looking at doing something that, where I have to look inwardly and be inspired by myself. And I think I'm kind of getting there, but this time has given me much more of an opportunity because I do so many other things. I used to manage a festival. I used to, kind of work with a lot of NGOs, and this has been a good time for me to kind of think about what else I can do. Art education has become such an important part of, our Indian art, because I think we're lacking a lot in it. And one of the things that I'm afraid that digitalization might do is it might kind of make us not want to visit the museum so much, or might not want us to visit art shows, or even kind of go out a lot to see, to even the BNRs, or to, you know, travel, or to. And I think a lot of artists need to go to these kind of events like art festivals and art fairs also. They need to interact with other artists. And I do hope that that continues to happen, because we're all kind of leading such an isolated life. So this is the downside of what we're going through. I also hope that we see a lot of young new artists emerge, as we haven't seen that happen in a while. We haven't seen a superstar emerge or come out of unlike we have a lot of old masters, and we have a few contemporary artists who have become very well known and who are really great at what they do, but maybe new media art that will emerge from this will be a sort of platform to experiment, and something great will come out of it. And I'm so looking forward to that, because we haven't seen that in quite a few years actually. Now, regarding my own work, back to my old own work, I have a lot of my work at home, and I look upon it as a legacy, maybe to my own kids. Maybe it's a little traditional in some ways, but it's also something that I find I keep the work actually. From each of my exhibitions, I keep one work because I find that these are the works that are really precious to me and my family. And we, in this time of isolation, I feel that it's kind of each of my work is talking to me, and I'm enjoying it so much that, you know, especially like this one, for example. I enjoy my work a lot, I enjoy looking at it, and I need it to be a sort of interactive, not just for me, but for everyone who lives in my home. I don't know about social change, what's going to happen, because of course it is going to happen, and art is going to change the social scene, whereas it's going to be the other way around as well, because it's like a catch-22 situation, you know, they're both related. And art is, of course, it's one of those things that make a statement about, you know, the times, as does literature, as does, you know, all the arts actually. I would love to go back to seeing, you know, a sort of show in a theater, which is live, rather than watch it on a screen and, you know, think that, oh, this is good. But there's nothing like actually feeling the work, or actually whether it's a dance or whether it's music or whether it is, you know, even just an art exhibition. One has to feel it with one's eyes, one's ears, one's senses. One has to sense it. And I think that can only happen when you actually watch it, look at it, listen to it, and relate to it. Thank you very much.